Good evening, everybody. So today we'll have a talk by Oleg Khudyakov, who will tell us about the Kegel competition, which is from the Child Mind Institute to predict the phases of the sleep. So thank you very much, Oleg, that you agreed to make this talk, and please start.
Greetings, everybody. I'm sorry for my English. It's far from being perfect, but I'll try my best. Today we will talk about this Kegel competition. I hope you see it on your screens. Detect sleep states. So how can we can understand from the name of competition, we have to predict the state of person. Does it sleep or does it awake or awakefulness? But if you will look at the data and the mathematical formulation of the task, the real task is not to predict state. The real task is to predict at moment at which the person onset to sleep or awakes. And this is the real task, to predict a specific moment, a specific with date and time at which the person goes to sleep and awake later. Let's look at data that given to us. We have parquet data file called train series or name train series. It's big enough, and I recommend you to use Polar's library instead of Pandas library to operate with data. I did some tests, and Polar's 3 to 5 times faster than Pandas, and it's really matters. Of course, if you make a submission, you can allow yourself to wait 2 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours. But if you make some experiments or you want to try some approach, it's much better to use Polar's library. It's really faster. So later I will show you notebook with very good Polar's code and fully commented. So you can use it if you're not familiar with Polar's yet. The train series file contains only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 columns. First column is series ID. Series ID is identificator or ID number of just ID label for some person which was wearing a bracelet to record data. Data was recorded only every 5 seconds, so time step is equal to 5 seconds, and every minute contains 12 steps. We have timestamp for each step. It contains data in form year, month, day. It contains time, also time zone. Maybe it can be useful for you. Sorry, it's not displayed here. Maybe this be better. Does it look better with this scale?
It's okay. For me, both is okay, but maybe this one is better.
And two type of data that bracelets can detect. First is angle. I think it's angle of rotation of your of wrist of person. And the last one is NMO. It's an acceleration. Euclidean norm minus one. I don't really dig deep into what is that. It's just an accelerometer data. So angle and acceleration. Two types of data which bracelet fitness bracelet can provide us. And this train series file contains a really big number of records. 127 millions of such records. It's big enough and contains nearly 277 series or 277 persons, which wears a bracelet for a different amount of time, from several weeks to month and more, or several days, sorry, from several days to month and more. And second file, which is given to us, is train events. It's really small, so we can read it with pandas. It's have a very small size. It contains only 14.5 thousands of records, and it contains only information about the events for training. Events are two types: on set, when someone goes to sleep, and wake up, when someone is awake. Also, every record for every event contains a series ID, step at which this event was occurred or just occurred, and the timestamp with year, month, day, time, and time zone. There are only two time zones in the whole data set, 4 and 5, or -4 and -5. Maybe you can use it in for further training. I just dropped. Now let's see how it looks. We have this wonderful notebook. I will later send you all the links for everything what I will show. This notebook allows us to visualize in a very clear and understandable format any data series. For example, this one.
Just a moment. So the what we need to predict, you will explain later, or we already should.
We have to predict the moment, the time, the step, or time when somebody goes to sleep, or onset sleep, and when this person awakes. We have to predict not a state really, we have to predict the moments, the events of onset of sleep and awake. And this notebook displays, allows us to display for. In this current picture, we have ENMO or acceleration. The blue graph is ENMO data, acceleration data from bracelet. Red lines are events of onset, of sleep onset, and green lines are events of awakes. This specific data series is long enough. From 17th of August to 5th of September. It's something about 3 weeks, 2 or 3 weeks. And it contains a lot of days with sleep onsets and awakes.
So we need to predict both onset and wake up, or only one?
Absolutely not. No. We have to predict and onset and wake ups. If we predict only onset and don't predict wake up, it fails. It doesn't count as an answer, as a correct answer. This picture is for same data series. But here we have angles recorded by bracelet, by fitness bracelet. It's same date, it's the same series ID, same person, same dates, same events, but different data. Here we have acceleration data, and here we have angles data. And such kind of data we have for every series ID, for every person, but some series are recorded good enough, and some series are recorded with very poor quality. We will discuss it later. Sorry, I have to see the plan of my talk. The next thing we will discuss is metric of competition. It's really important for us because...
Just a moment. In what file we have these targets or labels?
Labels of events we have in file named train events.
Ah, okay.
It's a pretty small file. It okay. have only less than 15,000 of records.
Mm-hmm.
And data and train series file has 127 million of mm-hmm. records.
And can you show us, please, some sample submission, or if there is some example of the submission file, how it should be kind of organized?
Yes, of course. It's given in data section of... Sample submission is on your screen. It have only four columns. Oh, sorry, five columns. Row ID is just index. Series ID, we can say it's a person for which we make prediction. A step is, we can say it's a current, it's a moment of time when we have the event. Because step is very strictly linked to time step, timestamp. Step is and timestamp are the pretty same, but in different format. For which person, for which series ID, step and timestamp are unique.
Yeah,
and we have, sorry?
The first big file, it contains both for train and for test. Is it correct?
No, no. First big file contains only train series, only train.
Okay.
Test series, which are given in data set, are really small, and as it usual on code competitions, real test data is hidden from us.
Yeah, it's a code competition, so
yes, it's a code competition. It's a code competition, so test data is hidden.
Okay.
This test series parquet file is mm-hmm. just to debug, just to make your code to work correctly.
Okay.
Real test data is hidden and we can't get it.
Mm-hmm.
It's normal for code competition.
Yeah. Okay. Can you show, please, the submission again, please? So what code
yes, of course.
Do we have there?
1 minute. Sample submission. So we have for each series given in test data, or we can say for each person, we have to predict in which moment or in which step of this data series we have an onset and wake up, and which probability. This column mm-hmm. must contain probability of onset and probability of wake up.
Okay.
The last column.
Okay.
But as I understand, this column score doesn't use for calculation. Now we will discuss the metric of competition to understand what we are really predict. This notebook describes it completely. Our metric for each event is discrete, not continuous. It can have value from 1.0 to 0 with step of 0.1. The absolute correct prediction give us for any event give us 1.0 if the error is less than 1 minute or 12 steps. On this picture, we have solid line. It's a true event, and dash dot line is not prediction, just stated event. If the difference in time is more than 50 minutes, or we can say more than 360 steps, our score will be just zero and no more. If the difference is between 25 minutes and 30 minutes, we have score of 0.1. Sorry, I haven't told. There are several tolerances: 1 minute, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 7.5 minutes, 10 minutes, 12 and a half minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 25 minutes, and 30 minutes. And these tolerances results in score. If our prediction have an error less than 1 minute, we have score of 1. If our prediction have error not more than 3 minutes, we have score for this event 0.9, and so on. For 5 minutes error or less, we have 0.8. For 7.5 minutes error, we have 0.7. And for error between 25 minutes and 30 minutes, we have score of 0.1. If our error of prediction is more than 30 minutes, we have zero score. That's the main idea of competition metrics. So I really don't understand what for we are predicting the score, the probability of event. It's unclear for me. I can't explain this, but the only thing we should consider is a difference in time between true events and predicted events. And this notebook displays it really clear. When the difference is decreasing, our score is really goes high. And if the difference between the true event and predicted event is less than 1 minute, we have maximum score of 1.0 for specific event. And our final score is an average of predictions for every event we have made, and also every event that we have in test data labeled. And it's a very tricky moment because, as we can see at visualization of data, not every series ID was recorded with good quality. Some series were recorded with very poor quality. If we look at this series, we can see it almost for every day we have onsets and awakes. Let's see it in bigger scale. But we can see in this, between the 17th and 21st, right here we have, sorry, I can't understand, do you see it or not? But
yes, we see.
We have some skipped events. We have some skipped events. 1, 2, 3 or more times events are skipped. But where we have a much worse series, much worse. For this series was recorded with very poor quality. We have predictions for less part of days. And a lot of days, bigger, most part of days have no labeled events. And yeah. if we predict any event in these days or on these dates, we will have score zero for them. It's a very tricky moment. We have to predict only at events which are labeled in data.
Yeah, but so how the metric is making a penalty if we predict if we just predict the event every second?
Yeah, no. We not make predictions for every second. We make predictions for time when we are sure we have an event, or we predict we have an event, not for every second.
Just a moment. Just imagine, I'll send the submission file where I'll send say that event is every second. Then, of course, my events will be very close to true labels. But the problem is how. No, it's not a good prediction.
Okay,
But
I'll try
how
to
metric,
explain.
how metric making penalty for this stupid situation?
Okay, I'll try. I understand the question, and I'll try to explain. In each day, we have certain number of time steps. We can calculate 24, the number of hours in day, times 60, number of minutes in hour, times 12, because we have 12 time steps in each minute for 5 seconds step. We will have 70,280 time steps. But usually we have one event of onset and one event of wake up. If you predict onset and wake up for every time step in this day, you will have score of 2 divided by 70 hundredths, or so, sorry, 17,280. I'll try to show a calculator to explain what I mean.
So, do I understand correctly that it's something like that happens, that we calculating the average, and the average is so that means the sum divided by the number of our predictions, not on the number.
Absolutely correctly. Do you see a notepad file on the screen?
Yes, we see.
In each day, we have the following number of events: number of hours, times number of minutes, times number of steps. It equals to this number. But we have only two events. If you predict two events absolutely with absolute precision, you will have metric of 1.0. But if you have predict only two events, if you predict this number of events, you will have score of 's really a small number, so you have a score near zero.
Okay, I understand. Yeah. Okay. I don't know, Alexei. Do you understand? Is it clear? Any questions from the other colleagues? I mean, I'll just a moment. There is a question in the chat. By the way, now you can unmute yourself and ask question by voice. What if I really show in one event and predict it 1,000 events with the same time?
I believe I have explained. We have two true events. And if we predict 1,000 events for this day, we will have a maximum score of... Oh, sorry. This will be your...
Oleg, but indeed in chat there is a question. So why you divide 2,000? Subtle question.
Events.
Because you calculated for true events, yes? So
yes. We have two true events in a day.
Okay, so we divide related to true events, we divide by the our predictions. Yeah, something like that.
It's close, but not really so. We have a prediction we have a score for each prediction. Sorry. I believe metric can consider which for every true event should be only one correct prediction. And if it I believe it takes the closest one, and when it have considered the closest prediction, all other will be have score of zero. If you want to dig deeply in metric, the competition description contains very deep description of metric. I'll try to find it now. No, not here. It's in evaluation. Sorry. Okay, I'll send later a link to metric which given us by organizers of competition with real code of this metric, and you can learn it line by line. But I believe it considers only one prediction for any true event.
Sounds reasonable. So is it correct that the values of the metric is from 0 to 1? Yes?
Yes, for each prediction. For each prediction, we have correct, we have metric from 0 to 1 with step on of 1/10.
And can you show the leaderboard just to understand what are the kind of current scores just about?
No problem.
Just leaderboard on this. Yeah. So it's a... just a very high quality, it seems to be about 70%.
Yes. What average metric, average score of 0.75 means that this person, Ruby, have predicted in between of 1 minute. Metric is here. 1 minute error is perfect score. 3 minute error is 0.9. Between 5 minutes and 7.5 minutes, average accuracy of his prediction is between these two numbers.
Okay.
Because, I'm wrong. 1.0, 0.9, 0. No, I wasn't wrong. Between 5 minutes, it's 0.8. And this 0.7. So 75% of score is between 5 minutes and 7.5 minutes.
That seems to be quite a good predictions. Yes.
I'm agree with you. Completely agree. It's a nice high score, high accuracy.
Surprising, I would say, that it's possible to predict these phases of the sleep such precisely.
So, I believe real accuracy can be pretty high because we have a lot of series which were recorded with very poor quality, and we can predict them correctly. I will discuss it later. Okay, the first approach I have tried myself was pretty naive, pretty straightforward. I decided to... It's a task of multi-class classification. Because if we look at the data, one class of events is on set. Another class of events is wake up, and we have a lot of time steps when we have no events. It's a class 3, no event. And I tried to solve that problem in this way, but it was very poor way to go because we have a very high class disbalance. As I said before, every day we have 17 thousands of steps and only two events. One event for onset and one event for wake up. So we have very high class disbalance, and I spent near 2 weeks to make the model and prediction file. It's really complicated in this competition to make a prediction file. We have a lot of discussions with error on submission. But my score was about 0.2, 0.3, and it's a pretty low score. Later, I found a very good notebook. Now you can see it on your screens. Now it has a score of 0.45. We've been reclassification approach to this problem. I highly recommend you to study this notebook because it commented very well. And even if you change the type of model, author of this notebook uses very simple random forest model from Escalern library. Even if you go to some gradient boosting or to neural networks, this notebook contains code for work with Polars library, which works 3-5 times faster than Pandas, and I recommend you to study it. But what is the main idea from this notebook? Let's see at this picture. Here we see a very short series. It contains only 3 days because we have two events of onset and two events of wake up. And we have only 3 days and two nights recorded for this series. The main idea of this notebook is to predict a state. Does person is sleeping or is person sleeping or is it awake? Here we can see the probability of sleep state of person. So it's in orange, it's displayed in orange. If the probability is high, near to 1.0, we definitely can say the person is sleeping. And if the probability is low, near zero, we can state the person isn't sleeping, the person is awake. And it's a very simple and very clear and very clever way to solve this problem, because we can make very simple trick with files. We can merge the train events file with all the time steps, merge it with train series, and later we just mark as one state for sleeping and mark as zero state for awake, and the person isn't asleep. It can be done in a very simple way with backfill or forward fill, backfill, backfill, backward fill, forward fill commands of pandas or polars. And we have to solve bin reclassification problem. If we have zero score of probability, person is awake. If we have one score of probability, person is sleeping. And after that, we have just to, first thing we do is we rounding the probabilities. Probabilities are continuous. From 0 to 1, with no step, it's continuous value. But we round it. Every probability lower than 0.5 equals to 0, and any probability which is higher than 0.5 equals to 1. And we make it, name it preds. On this picture, the preds are green. We can see it. So blue is accelerometer data, orange is probability of person is sleeping, and green is our prediction. Does person sleep or doesn't not sleep? And after that, we just take first derivative from the prediction. Most of time, the first derivative will be equals to zero because we have no change in our green line. So from the left corner to red line of on sleep, we have preds equals to zero and first derivative also equals to zero. Then we have the red line, our prediction changes to from zero to one, and we have first derivative equals to one. And when our prediction changes from one to zero, we have first derivative equals to minus one. So we can mark our event. If we have the first derivative equal to zero, we have no event. If our derivative equals one, we have on sleep. If first derivative from prediction is minus one, we have awake. It's brilliant approach. I applaud to it. I was unable to make something simple, so simple and so clever. So I think of this notebook is clever guy. And everything this described is this notebook. This notebook can be, it was initial score about 0.4. And we very simple ways we can improve the score. We can use other models, for example, CatBoost or LightGBM instead of Random Forest from Scalern. We can add some more features. All the features are described here. If you will have enough time, we will discuss it. Also, we can use post-processing. Why we need post-processing, I'll try to show you. Because some of series, as I said before, were recorded with very poor quality. For example, this one. Some states are marked black, and for these periods, there are no labeled events. Such series are really hard to predict correctly. And if you will combine the visualization from this notebook with visualization of our predictions, we can see something like that. Sorry, just a minute. Well, in the center of the screen, you see that we have a lot of predicted events of on sleep and awake, but no labels for them at all. Or if we will see, we will look something on the left. For example, the first night, we see that we have, but the model predicted two periods, one short period of sleep and one long period of sleep. But labels have only one long period, one very long period. Yes, from red line to green line. In our data, it's one long period of sleeping, but model have predicted two periods. So even if we predict with absolute accuracy the red event and green event, anyway, we will have score of 0.5 because we have predicted two events that are not exist in data. So we need some post-processing for such type of predictions. Or if we look at second pair of events, now it's in the center of the screen, we can see that onset of sleep is predicted with very high accuracy, but awake is predicted much earlier. But I'm not sure, is the model make bad predictions or we have incorrectly labeled data? And so on. If we will look further, there are a lot of differences between predictions and true events. So the third way to improve the score is to use some post-processing. We can merge some events into one, or we can delete some events from prediction. It's all for competitors.
Олег, and this, can you explain how the features are constructed?
Yes, of course. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Sorry, 1 minute.
So, as far as I understand, the number of events is different for different people, for different IDs.
Yes, because some data was recorded with high quality, and some series were recorded with very poor quality. Okay. Some days were missed. Maybe this person just forgot to use the fitness bracelet. Maybe it was broken, or it has no charge. I don't know.
Yeah, okay. But so it's not clear for me. So you make features, I don't know, per person or maybe per day, if you make, how, what we, I mean.
We're making feature for every step we use to consider. For example, we have, 1 moment. Here we look at the train series data file, which contains a very big number of records. And we're making features for every line, for every row of this data file.
And we'll make them with something like a sliding window.
Absolutely correct. Yes, you are right. You're absolutely right.
And what will be the length of this sliding window?
It varies from... It depends only on fantasy of competitor. This notebook, which is public, uses 4 steps. 5 minutes, 30 minutes, 2 hours, and 8 hours. It's in minutes, not in steps. 5 minute window means 60 step window, because we have 12 rows of data for each minute with 5 second step. So in this notebook, it uses 4 dimensions of window, and it makes a rolling mean, rolling max, and rolling std for acceleration data and for angles data.
So how many features per event we'll have?
Let's look. I believe from in something about 10 in this public notebook.
Okay.
In my notebooks, I make something about 60 features for each row.
Okay.
And it works fast enough, even with CatBoost and GPU.
Okay. Okay. I see.
This notebook is highly recommended by me to study and to understand what can you do. Because it's the second one we will discuss today. The first one was my fail with multi-class classification. I think it has no perspective to use. And this notebook with bin reclassification, I think it's very good approach. And maybe it will able to get a medal in the end of competition, because I don't think that everybody should be able to use neural networks notebook. And the last one notebook we will discuss is this public notebook. At this time, it has a highest score of all public notebooks, and it's certainly in silver medals at this time, not final scoring, of course. We only 1 month of free available for this competition is passed. And this notebook is pretty difficult for me to understand. First reason, it uses PyTorch. I know nothing about PyTorch. All the neural networks I used were with Keras and TensorFlow made. So I really don't understand clearly what is going on here. It's the first difficulty for me to understand. But where second big difficulty is, this notebook is not full because no train code here. And weights for neural networks are hidden. They are in private data set. You can see it on your screens. Author of this notebook doesn't share with weights and doesn't share with training code, only prediction code. This notebook displays only inference or prediction with recurrent neural networks. But there are some links here.
What is Arch, the last link, because it's a Parkinson freezing, it was from another competition, something like that.
Yes, yes. Author of this notebook gives us three links. First link is main idea of notebook, and it's a mathematical approach. It's published in discussion section, and this approach is not a classification problem, it's a regression problem. Well, you can read everything on the screen. Offer of this approach offers following way. We must make a Gaussian for onset event and a Gaussian for awake event. The center equals to one in the event itself, where it's marked. Some time steps to the left and some time steps to the right, it decreases and equals to zero in most of time. And this man offers us to use this kind of Gaussian distribution to make a target. And later we will solve the problem of regression, not classification, regression. He claims that this approach is similar to Hitmap regression method. I don't know what is it. So it's time, it will take a lot of time for me to understand everything. The second link given us by author of notebook is data loader. This data loader was made for this competition and published. I believe it's very useful for people who uses Kaggle notebooks, Kaggle Jupyter, or Jupyter, Kaggle Jupyter notebooks, because it's limited in RAM, in memory. So efficient usage of memory is very important. And the last link is about the model which used. It's bidirectional recursive neural network with GRU units, not LSTM units. It was taken from the previous competition. An author of this notebook combined approach with Gaussian distribution for targets, independent distribution for onset event, independent distribution for awake event, used this data loader, used this model, and get a score of higher than 0.5. His current score, he's now in team with someone else and have score higher than 0.6. So it's not final version of his notebook. But I didn't work with this notebook for a lot of time, and I can't explain a lot of things here. I don't know how to make it to train a model. I believe it's everything I can tell at this moment. So if you have questions, I'll try to answer it.
Thank you very much for your talk, Oleg. Thank you very much for the interview.
Last thing, I will share the plan of my talk and every link. I want to send it to chat, to our chat. Sorry, 1 minute. I'll try to use.
You can maybe send it later, it's okay. Up to you.
My message is too long, it will be divided into parts. Problem overview we don't need. It's my private notebook, some with some codes. Data visualization is a really useful notebook. Metric understanding is really useful. Some notebooks with data. I forgot to told you about two notebooks. First one and is very useful data set. 1 minute. This data set contains only series with no non-events.
You're not sharing, Alec, the screen.
Sorry, one minute. 1 minute. But only to sorry. How can I share?
Just this green button typically shares.
Screen demonstration, yes, поделиться. This notebook link was sent to the chat. Contains only series with no nums. And final number of series is only 35 of also 300s. 35 on 277 data series have no non events. And this data set is pretty small and pretty useful because trained model were trained only on true events with no skipped dates. And I use it for training my models. Also, we have this notebook. I'll send it to. What do we have in chat? Yes, this notebook is made by me. My approach was slightly. More effective, I trimmed series to first non-event. So I use not only series with no nonce. I trimmed series to first non. Also, dropped the series which are shorter than 1 week. Main idea of this, I believe, weekend can make an effect because we can sleep on Saturdays and Sundays more than in work days. So this data set contains also have no non events, no dates skipped, but it also was made not only with series which have no non events at all. It also contains trimmed to first non event series. It's three times bigger than previous dataset, and I believe it can be used with to train much more, maybe not much, but more accurate models because it contains three times more data than previous notebook. And I believe this is a link to a bin reclassification notebook. Sorry, chat. It's a link to bin reclassification notebook. And this is a link to neural network notebook. And yes, I will share all the links. Sorry, it's not, last link wasn't neural network notebook. This is a neural network notebook. Of course, I'll share all the links to the Telegram channel, of course. Now it's everything that I was able to say. I am ready to answer your questions if I will be able to.
Thank you very much, Oleg. Great talk. Colleagues, any questions, suggestions, comments, whatever, you can unmute yourself. And Oleg, maybe you keep sharing the presentation or notebooks, just better than the kind of screen.
1 minute, please. What will we discuss?
I don't know. Maybe you can keep any notebook or... colleagues, any questions, comments, suggestions?
Do you see?
Yes, then... yes, it's okay. Okay, so can you show leaderboard, please? So how far the public solution is from the top? Where are the public solutions now?
Here is the score of the 0.567 is the score of best public notebook, but with no training. If we look to the code section of this competition, and sort the notebooks by public score. We have, I wasn't able to study these two notebooks. They are pretty fresh. They were published today, and I don't know what they contains, but anyway, all the public notebooks have score of 0.5 and higher, and on the leaderboard it can be a medal, bronze medal or silver medal now.
Okay, I see. There is a question in the chat, how to make post-processing.
Okay, let's look at this picture. I believe there are two main ideas for post-processing. For example, let's look at first night. True events talks us that there is one long period of sleeping, and model prediction gives us two periods of sleeping. So we have to merge it into one period. It's the first way to make a post-processing, to merge short events of sleeping. Also, we can suppose that this short period of sleeping during the light time of day, it's not a accurate prediction. So we can delete such short periods of sleeping. It's another way to make a post-processing. Anyway, I think it's very useful to make a visualization of your model predictions and compare it with true events and think how to make post-processing of model to make your predictions as close to true events as possible. And another moment we have to discuss it showed directly in, sorry, I have a lot of tabs open. This text was given in description of competition. Fourth, each series is continuous recording, where there may be periods in the series when the accelerometer device was removed. These periods are determined as those were suspiciously little variation in the accelerometer signals occurred over an extended period of time, which is unrealistic for type of human participants. Events are not annotated for these periods, and you should attempt to refrain from making event predictions during these periods. An event prediction will be scored as a false positive or false positive. So another direction for post-processing, another approach to post-processing. If you have a very strange period, for example, at this picture, sorry. This black period should have no predictions at all. And you can use this series to predict events by your model and see, do you have a predictions or do you haven't? And if you have predictions of sleeping and awakening in this period of if no events, you should think about how to delete these predictions, because they will, if you have a prediction here, it will lower your final score. I think it's the most obvious and very useful ideas for post-processing.
Ivan, is it okay? Does it answer your question? Any other comments, suggestions? I have another question. Do they mention how they make this labeling? How they kind of control the person is really sleeping or not?
I'm not sure about this. Maybe it was written in the overview in description of competition, but I don't remember that they were so I don't remember they given us this information.
There is another question. In the
yes,
test do we have the same data with unlabeled periods?
I believe yes. The test data will contain periods with no labels of events. I believe yes, it's true. And this problem of this competition is discussed in this topic. But I believe it's not a problem of ternary classification. I believe it's a problem of post-processing. It's my personal opinion. I can't guarantee it's the best approach. But I think it's much more simple to make some calculation, for example, for this black period. I'll try to open it once again. I believe it's much more simple in after you make a prediction, analyze once again the periods, and if you see that accelerometer data for some days has a low variation, to exclude these predictions from your file. I believe it's a very reasonable approach.
Okay. So, do I understand correctly? So, we have basically kind of sleep event and not sleep event. So
no, sleep event, it's a moment when you go, it's a transition period from awakefulness to sleep.
Okay.
And in another event, when you wake up and you are not asleep anymore. And
okay.
Our goal is to predict a specific moment of sleep onset and awake.
Okay. Okay. And so have you looked something like, do they correspond to this moment always in the night, or there can be just during the day they sleep? Or?
There are some nice EDA notebooks. Let's look at them. I think my notebook can work faster if I will close some tabs. Code section of competition contains several EDA notebooks, which are information, which contains a lot of information. And yes, there are some regularities in terms of sleep time, sleep onset time and awake time. Sorry, I don't remember which here. Hourly distribution on onset events. We can see that something about 22 hours
okay
is the most frequent time to sleep onset, and 6 o'clock and 7 o'clock are the most frequent hours for awake. I believe it's very useful to read the notebooks with highest scores, most upvotes, and it can best notebooks contain a lot of useful information. We have no enough time to discuss everything.
Yeah, sure. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. Colleagues, any other questions, comments, suggestions, whatever? Okay, if no questions, then thank you very much again. So wish you,
thank you.
Great success. So hopefully you'll get the prizes from this competition.
I would be glad to get any medal, but silver one, it will be just wonderful.
Okay, so colleagues, then good evening, everybody. And the links shared in the Kaggle forum, and they'll send share them in Telegram, and the video record will be also available, I hope tomorrow. And so good evening, everybody. And Alex, thank you very much again.
Thanks for your time. Goodbye.
Goodbye.